put this down. Oh, I gotta match the line. Like, okay, double. Aloha, welcome to Living Hope. This week, our guests, we have Tumua Tuinei, the king of all lands, Tuinei. That's right, the king of Instagram, the king of Facebook, and the king of comedy here in the islands. Find out the good news in tough times with your hosts, Don O'Brien and John Tilton. John Tilton on Living Hope. Aloha.
Aloha ohana. Quick, when I say island comedy, who's the first person you think of?
Old or new?
First person.
Dead or alive?
Don, simple as a pimple. First person.
Okay, I know, but Hawaii gets so much talent. I mean, Rap Replinger, what, Russell, get pen, to Uncle Frank De Lima, to the Bradas. I mean, give me a category, John, give me a clue.
Okay, first clue. He's been in the biz only 4 years, but already headlines and sold out the Blaisdell multiple times. Clue number two, just for you. He hangs out with big time talent like Joe Coy, Andy Bumatai, and Augie T. Last clue, this local comic loves God and comes to church every Sunday. We see him slipping in to the back row. Who is our mystery local comedian?
The one, the only, Tumua Tuinei!
Ding, 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 chicken dinner winner. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for a true talent in Tumua Tuinei.
And get ready for a true heart-to-heart, as he is the real deal local boy born and raised West Side. He's so local boy, he always sees me, he goes, Auntie Dawn, hi, Auntie Dawn. And I'm like, quiet with the auntie, Tumua. But somebody's raising him up right.
We can't wait for Tumua too much, Tuinei. But first, let's check in with this month's Good News Hawaii. Over to you, Donovan and Don.
Ready for some good news, Hawaii?
Well, ready or what? Here we come.
Today is a double scoop day. Two great stories right here in our Hawaii Nei to make your day.
Hui Nei. First up, lucky we live Hawaii, blessed we live paradise. More good things about Hawaii are coming back. It's the return of the regattas. This month, the very first canoe regatta race is launched after 2 years of being shut down due to COVID.
Thousands showed up for the OHCRA, or Oahu Hawaiian Canoe Racing Association races, here at Ke'ehi Lagoon. It featured a traditional Hawaiian blessing, hula, and song to open the perfect weather day.
Big and small clubs came together in the friendly spirit of competition, Polynesian culture, and much aloha. It was so neat to see Keiki to Kupuna enjoying a day together, and I actually overheard one lady say it was her first outing in over 2 years. Yeah, you choo-choo!
Our host and senior pastor, John Tilton, competed with New Hope Oahu Canoe Club and placed first in their division. And Don, I know that you competed with Huinalu as well. How did it go?
First race, first place, baby. Choo! Glory to God. You know, we're rookies, so we have a lot to learn as novice B, but more to enjoy. And much thanks to our coaches.
Awesome. Next, our second story is also near and dear to Hawaii's heart, our homeless ohana. IHS's Kahauiki Village provides affordable housing and assistance for the houseless and disadvantaged communities here on Oahu. They provide housing and much-needed resources to help families get healthy and succeed.
This month, they hosted a rededication celebration for the village ohana. It kicked off with a cleanup day by 24 volunteers led by Alan Castillo and Pastor Fred Alkane. Pastor Fred said, KV just needed an extra pair of hands to help out, so New Hope jumped in.
In addition, Kahushan Kiheva, one of our community care pastors, did the blessing and rededication. Although he gave the blessing, Kahushan said he himself was blessed when a resident shared how she lost all four of her children due to her lifestyle. But moving into the village and receiving their support and resources helped her get back on her feet and get all four of her keiki back.
Wow! KV also opened a brand new educational center with computers, monitors, games, all in an effort to bring the unity back into this community.
And New Hope is also partnering with IHS, the Institute for Human Services, who oversees the village to host fun outreaches and events for their youth, young adults, families, and kupuna.
Kahushan said, Kahauiki Village is a place of faith, hope, and love, where faith is a new foundation, hope is their character and attitude, and love is shown in their actions. Win, win, winning!
And that's your good news, Hawaii. Always remember, don't just look for the good news.
Be the good news.
Aloha!
So Tumua, it is so good to be here with you for Dawn and
I'm your biggest fan. Yes. I'm your hugest fan.
I know, she told me that four times as soon as I was walking
in. 60 seconds. I am your biggest fan, Tumua.
Oh, thank you.
And for me, when I realized that you actually started at New Hope Oahu when you were a small, young
Farrington Days.
Yep, yep.
And that your parents were here a long time from Farrington Days. And to see you here, and to see how successful God has allowed you to be, mm-hmm. and know that you still sneak into the back row and watch service.
So humble this boy, I tell you.
Maybe we can start from there is, you know, everyone now knows you, and I heard you're selling out shows, but God was doing something with you from the very beginning, how you grew up with your parents, and then sports, and how did you jump into comedy,
right?
I mean, you know, it's such an interesting transition.
It is. Yeah. Even myself, I was surprised because I never knew.
Surprised.
Yeah, I never knew I was going to be a comedian. You know, I always wanted to be an actor. That was something that I wanted to do. But yeah, like you said, sports was a huge part of my life, and especially because my dad and my uncle. My dad is Tom Tuinei, and my uncle is Mark Tuinei, my dad's brother. So yeah, my uncle played Dallas Cowboys. You know. Yeah, this is our year.
Wow.
Oh gosh, now we're going there.
Now we're going there.
Let's go back to comedy.
If it's not our year, then next year will be our year. Like, every year is our year. But football was my main passion, and I played football at Punahou, you know.
UH,
yeah.
And then you pivot left into comedy. When did that happen?
I took a stand-up comedy class at UH. So
nice.
I just took it just because, you know, I saw it on the class description. I was like, oh, that's an easy A. So me and my teammate, we took that class, took it, and it turned out that I really enjoyed it. For our final presentation, we had to perform a live 10 minutes in front of an actual audience at a bar. And I did great. You know, I killed, and then some comedy promoter saw me there, Jose Dynamite. Shout out to Jose Dynamite. He runs local shows here. But yeah, he saw me, and he kept telling me to come back, and I just kept doing shows, did some stuff with Augie T, Andy Bumatai, and then I haven't stopped since. It's been about 4 years of doing stand-up.
Talk about a roll, and you're still rolling.
It is.
You're rocking and rolling.
Yeah.
And if you think about it, it was perfect timing, Tumua, because we were all locked inside. Yeah. Is that part of the success of Tumua Tuinei?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I did stand-up for about 4 years, but I only started making videos a year ago back in 2020.
Instagram at Tumua_.
Tumua_, yeah. So like when the pandemic happened in March, you know, and everything got shut down, I had a monthly show at Ko'olau Golf Course at Honey's Restaurant. I'll perform there every second Fridays of the month. And that got shut down with COVID. And then I was like, okay, am I just gonna stay at home and not do nothing, you know, or am I gonna try produce some stuff? And then people kept telling me, oh, you gotta post skits, post videos, post sketches. And I was like, nah, I'm a stand-up comedian, you know? I don't even do that kind of stuff. And then, nothing wrong with that. Yeah. You know, I got some friends who are strictly, you know, Instagram comedians like that. And then, so I put out like a video, me and my dad put up this toilet paper drug dealing video.
I saw that, yeah.
Classic, hilarious.
Yeah, that same day, it went on the news and, It went viral, so I was like, okay, I guess this is what local people want. So I kept putting more and more videos out, and then my followers just expanded. And
I got to tell you some of my favorites. So I love the one where you are doing samples at Costco, right? And that was pre-BC, before COVID. Then you just did one about the chiropractor, I love my chiropractor, but that stuff was hilarious.
That was a recent one, yeah. She is a fan.
I'm a total fan.
So whether you're a comedian or a pastor trying to come up with content, mm-hmm. where does this come from? Because
yes,
some of it is
kind of
just
material.
Not only hilarious, but good kind deranged.
Yeah. stuff that I experienced with my family, you know, and I want to make it relatable to the local people.
Yeah,
so I want people to watch my stuff or see me on stage and be like, I know that guy. That guy reminds me of my uncle. That guy reminds me of my cousin. He acts just like my dad. Or I just experienced that the other day at Home Depot. Yeah. You know, so the main thing is being relatable. And I feel like there's so much stuff that happens in Hawaii. And I feel like we're a funny state. You know, we have so much races. You know, we're a mixed plate of ethnicities. And if we all just, you know, come together as one, and I feel like laughter is a big thing that we can share together.
But talk to us about mom and dad, because they are a big influence on your life.
Oh, yeah, definitely. They're my number one fans. They come to every single one of my shows, even if I'm doing, you know, like at Blue Note, I did like 18 shows in a row. And yeah, you're sold out. And they come to all of them. And they're my number one supporters. And my dad is actually, you know, a tough critic. So he'll tell me if something's not funny or not. Any idea that I have, I always try to run it by him first, because he'll be honest about it and be like, oh, that's not funny. That's not that. But I can say some things he said that's not funny, and it still did good. So there you go. That's camera one or camera two? Which one am I looking at?
You're
that
looking
one.
Either which one.
Okay.
Yeah. When I was telling Kelly Boy from Kapena yesterday, I said, yeah, I was talking to Tumua, and he said, oh, yeah, but I know when it's not funny, but when it maybe is funny, my dad says, oh, that one has potential.
Potential, right? Yeah, that's the word. Yeah, that one has potential.
But here, people see you in all of your success, but I know that there's a walk that you walk with the Lord. And so how do you put together your walk with the Lord and all that you're doing right now, you know?
Yeah, by faith, you know, I try to create a strong relationship with God. I'm always open for improvement like everybody else. You know, I got to get more into it. But I've been, my dad and my mom has planted that seed of, you know, God in me since I was a young kid, just by going to Farrington, you know, New Hope since I was small. And then the roof
and you had came. A Portuguese pastor that would crack jokes all the
exactly,
time.
Yeah. That was my favorite time in service, you know. So maybe that was my influence with
there
Pastor Wayne. I don't know. Yeah.
But you know why? Tumua, what's so amazing is because many comedians nationally are world-renowned, but they have to depend on content that's maybe risque or, you know.
True.
And yours is all clean, but just totally hilarious, you know. So and it connects.
It is, because if you guys know me off stage, and I'm a clean person. I don't smoke or drink.
Wow.
And I never have before. And, I mean, I don't really curse off stage as well. So it was easy for me to do clean comedy.
Ladies. No, I'm kidding. That's the kind of man you're looking for. That's the kind of man you're looking for.
Amen.
So it was easy for me to do clean comedy. It started off when I started doing work with Augie T and Andy Bumatai. And, you know, they're clean comedians as well.
Right.
And just like the brothers too. And they told me, if you want to, you know, succeed in Hawaii in the entertainment business, especially in comedy, you got to keep it clean because there's a lot of keiki here and, you know, you're going to have more people at your shows. So at my shows, I have, you know, kids all the way to like the tutus, you know, so there's a big age variety there. And I like to keep it that way, especially in Hawaii.
Yeah. Yeah. That's so good.
You know, we're going to come back with Tumua Tuinei. He's the king of comedy and we just love him. You can get in line behind me. I'm the number one fan, me and his parents. But we're going to come back with a little bit more from Tumua Tuinei in just a heartbeat. Stay with us.
Do you ever feel anxious or worried? If you do, can I encourage you? Your life is like a canoe. It's being paddled in a particular direction. It may be towards your calling, or it may be away from your calling, but you are in the steersman's seat. Your destination will be determined by what you choose to steer that canoe with. Are you steering your canoe with a paddle of anxiety? Maybe you're steering holding on to worry. In moments when you feel anxiety, remember that there are many others in your boat who are there to support you. Realize that your self-worth is more important than what's inducing anxiety in the first place. Your life is greater than your present moment, and your purpose is too important to quit right now. Paddle toward your purpose, and when you do, you'll find that even today, hope is alive.
Discover hope this weekend at New Hope Oahu. For more information, visit enewhope.org.
I am super stoked that we're doing round two with the Tuineis. 15 years ago, I was on Connecting Point with your dad, Tom Tuinei. And today we're here with Tumua Tuinei, carrying on the tradition of the Tuinei dynasty. Yeah. Question I have for you, a lot of comedians have like a routine they do before they go out on stage. Do you have a routine? Because you don't drink, you don't smoke. Well, what do you do to get hyped?
Shoot, I mean, I say a prayer for one, yeah. Just, you know,
nice.
I pray to God really hard and make sure.
He's just
whatever.
Saying this because he's next to Auntie Don.
Pastor John.
No, I'm serious.
And this is his pastor.
Yeah, I say a prayer, and then I kind of just keep to myself. I don't like people talking to me that much, and just go over like my set list of what I want to want to say. I mean, I still get nervous, you know.
Do you?
People always ask me, does the nerves go away? But no, it's still there. And it's not as much as it was before.
Right.
But I think it's important to be nervous. I'm sure you get nervous before you give it. Yeah. It's funny.
Everyone, yes.
Some other pastor from another church came up to me and asked for some pointers because apparently, like, they study comedians as well, just to hold the audience
and
keep them attentive the whole time, right?
And the hardest is when you drop a line in a joke and they don't laugh, but they always laugh for you.
On your words.
Yeah, exactly.
So, being nervous, it keeps you alert, you know. Yes. So it's good to be nervous.
It's a lot of adrenaline, right? It has to be a lot like football and charging the field.
Oh, it's almost similar. I like to compare the two sports. I call them sports because you know I sweat on stage, so I gotta stretch before I get up there. But definitely like football because you know you get that pregame jitters, you know.
Yes.
And as soon as you get on that field, whether you're flying down on kickoff or you know catch that first pass, you know the jitters go away a little bit and you feel more relaxed. Same thing with stand-up. As soon as you get on that stage, you crack that first joke, you hear that first laugh.
And you connect.
Yeah.
And then I love it.
I like the nerves, and it humbles you too. You don't want to get to the point, or I don't want to get to the point where I'm like, oh, I got this gig, I got this show, I can make these people laugh. And then I go up there and I bomb, you know. So I like to be humble and be nervous, so it helps me a lot.
You know what's so cool is how you've grown into what you're doing. And it happened very naturally. Mm-hmm. You know, what does that come from?
So I minored in theater at UH. So I was kind of comfortable with being on stage and dealing with audiences. And also I did magic too when I was
there
young.
There it is. Yeah. So, you were always a performer.
Yeah, I was always a performer. So I used to do a lot of magic when I was young. And I enjoyed that. I enjoyed, you know, performing in front of people and seeing their reaction and all that. So I guess that's what, you know, made me feel comfortable or natural, as you say, you know?
Yeah. I love that you draw a lot of inspiration from your mom. Can you tell us about your relationship with mom? Like,
my mom, I mean, yeah, she's
Portuguese.
Portuguese number one fan. Okay. She's 110% Portuguese.
Not Portuguese. Is there any other variety?
No other variety, no. But yeah, if you ever see me perform, I talk about her a lot on stage. She's not too much in my skits. She doesn't really like to be on camera, but she's maybe in one or two of them in my videos. I gotta look back, but I talk about her on stage, just the Portuguese stuff she does, you know. Yeah. Kind of make this thing up, you know. always asking questions, you know. She always calling me constantly, where are you at, or she called me and I go, oh yeah, what's up mom, and she goes, oh sorry, I forgot I was gonna tell you. I'll call you back later, you know.
So much good stuff. Now when I think about your whole family, there is a lot that your mom and dad went through before they got together with each other. They also had kids before you.
Yep.
And then they get to you. Do you think that influenced at all? Because you kind of shared off camera about how your uncle died. Mm-hmm. That actually inspired you for greatness. He inspired you both in life and when he passed. Yeah. But also your dad went through some trouble with the law and they turned their lives around and invested that in you. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, that's the reason why I don't, you know, touch alcohol or drugs is because of those two guys. You know, my uncle passed away from drugs and my dad, you know, went to prison from drugs. Oh. So that's what my dad always says. Like, if you go this route, you're either gonna die or end up in prison, you know. So my dad got lucky and he ended up in prison and God gave him a second chance.
Yeah.
And he has a, you know, a great job now, and he supported, you know, my punho career and UH and all that. And he always reminds me, like, you know, just, you know, stay close with God and to never touch those things because that messed him up big time. So I just look at them too as examples, and hopefully I can lead the younger, you know, generation is that as well. I mean, I don't have kids yet, but when I do, you know, I'm going to tell them the same thing my dad told me. And so I'm thankful that my dad did that. And I personally think everything happens for a reason, you know, like the whole pandemic and everything. I like to look at everything positive. And same thing with football. You know, I loved football so much and I really wanted to, you know, go to the NFL, like my father and my uncle.
Yeah, sure.
And like a big thing of me, with me was getting a scholarship out of Punahou, and I never got one, you know, because I was, you know, maybe too small or whatnot. And that kind of hurt me a lot. And even when I got to UH, I ended up earning one my junior year with Nick Rolovich. But I never really played that much, and that kind of hit me hard. And that's actually during that same transition is where I found comedy. So that's another thing that, you know, when God closes the door, at that point I knew, okay, I have to put away this football career and this hopes. And then another one opened up that I didn't even know about, you know. So if I didn't go to UH, I don't think I would have been a comedian. If I went to a small school, some small, you know, NIA school or D3 school, I would probably play a lot more, but I wouldn't have found my passion now. So
everything happens for a reason. I love that you say that, Tumua. Yeah. Exactly. Everything happens for a reason. And we know that the Bible, the good book says that God works all things together for good. Even the things you look and you go, what? Lockdown, pandemic, my uncle passed away from an overdose. But God uses that and he builds you up. Yep. He really does have a plan for a future.
And you know, one of our favorite scriptures, Jeremiah 29:11. That his hope for you and his plans for you are for goodness and greatness. And to see how even with your dad and then with you in your sports, how God had a plan. And then through both your dad's testimony and what you went through, he was giving you life experiences and life lessons and actually guiding you toward where you are today. That is amazing, you know, because that's who we become. From our life experiences and our life lessons.
Especially with the pandemic, I really think that I blew up because of the pandemic, because everyone is on their phones and nothing. I mean, I don't know, people say it's just...
That makes sense.
But it makes sense to me,
totally,
you know?
Totally makes sense.
And that's when I first started putting out skits and all that, and so I think that helped me a lot. So I learned to be thankful for the pandemic.
And even you have hundreds of thousands of followers. That's when I found Tumua Tuinei, was during the pandemic lockdown. And I'm like, okay, I need a laugh. I'll give this guy a chance. I haven't stopped ever since. I'm still stalking him. And here I am sitting on set with him today. Thank you so much.
Which also brings us to 2020 was a great year for you. You sold out shows at the Blue Note, at the NBC.
Concert hall.
What does 2022 hold for you?
God willing, I can keep doing more shows. Yeah. I mean, my manager and I, shout out to Greg Azuz. He's been a wonderful person to me and my manager. We got some shows lined up. We're going to hit the Outer Island, so give them some love.
Yes, you know? Yes, yes.
And also hit the local mainland pockets, so definitely Vegas. Some spots in the West Coast. Yeah, so... Everything's still like jumping around because of COVID and restrictions, but we'll have some dates lined up for everybody.
That is so exciting.
Tumua's going huge nationwide. Hey, and you got to hit the other island, not just the ninth island, but Tonga Island. We are waiting to laugh. I'm just putting that out there.
I'm going to have you open for me then.
Yes, absolutely. And I can double as your bodyguard. There's a beauty in that multitasking. Tumua, you know, we're all about living hope. We're coming in for a wrap. Is there something you would say to someone having a really hard season or a hard day?
Yes.
What would you say to that individual who's looking for hope?
I would say just don't give up, you know. That's just the motto. I lived it since I was young too, and my dad implanted that to me. And no matter how hard challenges may get, you know, God's not going to make a challenge harder that you can't handle, you know.
Right.
So just don't give up. There's always hope at the end of the line, and there's always a light there, and just keep pushing. If you need someone to talk to, you can always reach out to me. I can hopefully try and make you laugh. Yeah. But yeah, just don't give up. I mean, pray to God, build a relationship with him, and don't be discouraged if a door shuts down or a dream, you know, shuts down. There's always going to be another one, just like how I found comedy through all this madness.
And he's a perfect example, Tumua Tuinei. You know, they say the joy of the Lord is our strength, and this guy's a superhero of God's joy.
Amen.
Thank you, Tumua, for joining us today.
Thank you guys
we
so
love
much.
You.
It's been such
Thank
a pleasure.
You.
Thank
it.
You.
Aloha.
Aloha.
If I'm being honest, when we first came to New Hope, we were a bit nervous.
I didn't know anyone here.
This whole Christianity thing? Kind of weirded me out.
But we both soon discovered.
That's exactly what we needed.
Here at New Hope, I found a place where I belong.
Where I found my new besties.
A place where my children can grow up.
And a place to grow old with a young yet heart.
Here at New Hope, I found my voice.
A place where I can be creative.
And worship God with my whole heart.
I found freedom.
A second chance in life.
A place where I'm loved just as I am.
New Hope is home.
It's family.
There's a place for you.
So join us this weekend at New Hope Oahu, and soon you'll find that even today, hope is alive.
For more information, visit enewhope.org.
There is a Hawaiian saying, or olelo no eau, lana kako ika hauʻole o haʻi. It means we rise by uplifting others. Tumua is a son of Hawaii who rises by uplifting us all with so much joy.
Be sure to follow Tumua on IG for his skits and daily shenanigans, and stay tuned for more on his upcoming tour. So impressed, Tumua. You make Auntie wanna chee-hoo! Yeah, you!
Once again, mahalo ohana for taking time to hele mai e ai, to come to the table and break bread together. It's all about putting the unity back into community.
After all, we are the Aloha State. Our first name is Aloha. It's our strongest identity and living hope, Aloha.
Our prayer is that no matter what, you will always have a living hope. From all of us to all of you, Aloha!
Jee-hoo!
Stepping down from light to darkness, the Son of God is here with us. The chains of sin forever broken, your perfect peace has conquered all your love. Is changing us. You embrace the broken hearted, bringing hope to life again, adopted in your perfect kingdom, the Word of God. Change.